about PVR. I thought it was like a vaccine for the flu or something. And then I'm learning, folks, a 1992 PVR Griffith convertible, they're unloading this week for $50,000. And is it Oxfordshire? How do you say that?
You got that right, yeah.
Oxfordshire, yeah. What is a TVR, Paul Mortimer Lee? And is the president going to slap a tariff on it?
They don't make them anymore, so it doesn't make any difference.
Okay, but this weekend he was talking about those foreign autos, whether it was a TVR or a BMW. We're going to go after the foreign autos.
Well, that's if the European Union retaliates against the steel. Mr. Juncker said that it was stupid to get into a trade war, but you know, Currently the European Union puts a tariff of 10% on US cars, so they're already being pretty stupid. And I think, you know, this has been long brewing, and the massive size of the German current account surplus was bound eventually to lead to problems, and the Europeans just haven't tackled that.
It's worth pointing out, and I think for many of our listeners who already understand that trade is incredibly complex, but on the issue of autos, it's quite clear. There is a tariff, as you say, of 10% on US imports into Europe. The tariff on European car imports into the United States is 2.5%.
Exactly.
You know, we can cherry pick other examples that it will show the opposite maybe, but the bottom line for me is, Paul, is that no one seems to have the moral high ground on trade, and it's certainly not Europe.
Absolutely. You're dead right. And we can see with Europe talking to the UK and really threatening to restrict trade with the UK.
$70,000 BMW. The tariff is $7,000 coming into the United States.
It's only two and a half.
So it's, what's that, $1,400?
Yeah.
No, that's 100. Whatever. It's four times as much.
Yeah.
Going the other way.
Yeah, exactly. So,
you see, John, how I butchered that math?
You did. So you got it right in the end. Well done. It's still early coming. It's Monday morning. Paul, bottom line at the moment.